The U7 Pro Max is one of Ubiquiti's latest Wi-Fi 7 access points. It has the same form factor and 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port as the U7 Pro, but it adds additional transmit power for more coverage area. It also bumps up to 4x4 MIMO in the 5 gigahertz spectrum to handle more client devices. The U7 Pro Max also includes an additional radio, which is dedicated to real-time spectral analysis, and that's what I'm going to focus on in this video. Let's get started. Over the weekend, I installed the U7 Pro Max as the main access point in my home. It's up in the attic, mounted to a rafter, centrally located, and pointed downwards to cover all of the lower levels. Now, I am a bit concerned about heat up in the attic. The U7 Pro and the U7 Pro Max both have fans inside to deal with heat dissipation, but they're also rated for up to 140 degrees Fahrenheit or 60 degrees Celsius, so hopefully it'll be fine. We'll see how it holds up when we hit the hot parts of summer. My Unify network controller is version 8.2.93, which I just updated to yesterday. The update went fine and everything seems to be working okay. When I click on Unify devices and then click on the U7 Pro Max, we now have a spectrum option that shows up underneath the name of the device. Clicking on it brings us to the radios page under the environment tab, where you can select different access points in the upper left-hand corner. If I click on an access point that doesn't have the real-time spectral analysis, it just looks like this. We get some basic information about other wireless SSIDs that are detected by the access point, but really, it's just a point-in-time SSID channel and detected signal strength. Clicking on the U7 Pro Max, however, shows us a lot more. Up at the top, we now have the choice of spectrum or interference. Interference being the same info that we get with the other U7 access points. Within spectrum, however, we can choose which wireless band we want to analyze, 2.4 gigahertz, 5 gigahertz, or 6 gigahertz. The waveform graph up at the top shows us all of our channels and which ones are currently broadcasting traffic. This type of information is super useful when it comes to planning out deployments. If you have neighbors or nearby businesses that are hogging up a bunch of the wireless spectrum, you can set your own access points to channels that don't interfere with their traffic. But since point-in-time measurements aren't really ideal for, you know, constantly evolving wireless networks, they also have a waterfall graph that shows you the past minute worth of wireless activity. Or in other words, every second, the information from the waveform graph up above transfers down to the waterfall graph down below so that you can see changes in history for the past 60 seconds. Most simply, when looking at this waterfall graph, green means very little has happened in that part of the wireless spectrum, and yellow or red represents areas of the spectrum with higher amounts of traffic. You want to try to avoid those areas. Let's now analyze the waterfall graphs from my own U7 Pro Max in real time. All right, so looking at 2.4 gigahertz, we can see that as of right now, just looking at the waveform graph, everything looks pretty good across the board. It's pretty utilized up here around channel 11. Down here on channel 1, we're seeing some activity. 6 is also the other main 2.4 gigahertz channel, and everything looks mostly okay as far as point in time. But if we look at this over time, if we look at the waterfall graph, we can see that there's a lot of red on channel 1. So over time, that channel is getting utilized pretty well. Same thing with channel 11. Now, channel 6 did have this blip where something, you know, popped up and used some of the bandwidth, but overall, channel 6 looks like the clearest channel that I'm seeing according to the spectrum analysis. If we now look at the 5 gigahertz, everything looks pretty good across the board here. And if we look at the waterfall, we can see that up here around channel 157, we've had some pretty significant activity, so I'd probably want to avoid that channel. We can see 124 is spiking up right now and doing some stuff, and we see that translated down here into the waterfall graph, and we've seen a couple of other blips on other channels, but by and large, 5 gigahertz is pretty clear in my area. And finally, we get to 6 gigahertz, and we can see that everything looks really, really clear. These are probably my devices doing stuff on Wi-Fi 7, but I'm pretty sure I'm the only person in the neighborhood who has Wi-Fi 7 access points so far. So yeah, perfectly clear wireless spectrum in the 6 gigahertz. So what can you do with this other than, you know, manually changing the channels of your access points to other channels that aren't as utilized? for now, it doesn't look like there's much, right? I wasn't able to find any information about this real-time spectrum analysis being used for automatically setting access point channels or anything like that. However, in the launch video for UI's new Wi-Fi 7 access points, they do mention that eventually we're gonna have Next AI continuous packet capture capabilities. But since that's a feature coming in a future version, we're just gonna have to wait and see what that can do. All right, what do you guys think about the new U7 Pro Max access point? Let me know down in the comments below. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my recent review of the new U7 Pro wall access point, and the bottom video is my full wireless design for the silver mining ghost town of Cerro Gordo, California.